last 3 weeks, our six celebrities have been on a mission to find their perfect plus one. Joey Essex, Stephanie Pratt, Paisley Billings, Tyger Drew Honey, Jack Jones, and Charlotte Crosby. Tonight.
Today's going to be hopefully very euphoric with a little bit of emotion.
Who are you trying to kid? This is a battle between me brain and me beaver.
It's dinner party dates.
Steph, my hurt joy.
Did I miss something?
This is so embarrassing.
Do you feel like we're making you look bad because you didn't do your job?
Ooh.
I've like seen in the papers that you've got a fella.
And for the last time.
It feels so bad.
The celebs.
Where the fuck is his date?
Go.
Thank you.
Dating. The celebrity dating agency is shutting up shop. Sorry, Taylor Swift. Next series, eh?
Gross.
But by the end of tonight, we might just witness the birth of six new celebrity power couples. Nadia and Eden will be throwing a celebrity dating agency dinner party for all the celebs. But who will they invite? And more importantly, will they show up? This plus one should be the person they think they can build a relationship with, not just a drunken snob. Charlotte?
Okay, maybe not.
But before we can get to that, Joey is still in a bar trying to figure out how to dump model Becky. But he better hurry up, as Steph's waiting for him nearby.
I can't have you leading on our client.
Mate, this is long.
Don't do a runner again, Joey.
Hi.
Hey, hi.
That was Nadia, sorry.
What did she say?
About just some dinner party thing.
What did you say?
Well, basically, this is what's happened is... Oh, this is gonna be so cringe. I've gotta take someone to the dinner party, yeah?
Yes, we all know about this bloody dinner party.
And... Basically, I've got to see myself, like, in a relationship with this girl.
Mm.
It's a bit awkward, really.
We've got that, Joey.
That's awkward.
I don't know. Well, I think obviously you're beautiful in that,
mm-hmm.
But...
But what?
I can't tell you. That's what's happened.
That's fine.
Fine? I thought we'd be more bothered than that.
I bet this whole journey's been mad. I mean, meeting someone else.
Wait, I'm really confused.
I don't think he's confused, Becky. I think he just wants to hook up with Steph Pratt again. Sorry.
I don't really know if I can say.
Joey, you do know how TV works, right? She's going to see this.
I totally bottled telling her about Steph.
I feel like you've handled it quite well because I didn't want to upset you.
No.
Good.
No.
That's good then, isn't it?
Yeah,
that's
friends.
Brilliant. Friends? I'm not sure you're ever going to speak to her again.
I've kind of had, like, an inkling that something was, like, not right.
Yeah. See you later.
See you later.
See you later. I let that girl down. I know she liked me a lot, so it was like, for me, that was just difficult.
I don't know. I just hope whoever it is that he's happy with them.
So it's the end of the road for Becky and Joey. All right, mate.
Everything is done with Becky. There's one person that I want to see.
He can't wait to get his end away with Miss Peter, ATT. He better hurry up. Steph's waiting for her Essex salted potato to arrive.
God, am I... happy to see you.
First of all,
what?
I'm so happy you're here.
Oh, yeah, Stephanie Pratt. What are you saying?
Tell me, was she shocked?
Yeah, she was shocked, but she handled it well.
Oh, as if she was fine. No girl is ever fine when they get dumped. I know I want to be with you.
Yeah, same.
You make me so happy.
We both know. I know for a fact you know as well. This is going somewhere.
You know
I think it is.
It is, you know it is.
The Pratts? Stowie? Jeffany? Nah. I like Jeff myself. It's classy, simple, yet authoritative.
I think you're perfect for me.
You're same. I've never met someone like you who makes me laugh as much as you do, to be honest.
Love me.
Do I love you? Not quite yet.
Get a room. Oh, you've already done that. OK, that's enough from The Only Ways Made in Celebs Go Dating. It's the last day in the agency before Eden and Nadia shut their doors to our celebrity clients. Ahead of the dinner this evening, each celeb has a final consultation.
Good morning, cherub.
A chance for some awkward sofa chat. Oh, and to see what they've learned.
Well, this is it.
Yeah.
Today's going to be an absolute roller coaster.
Today's going to be, hopefully, very euphoric with a little bit of emotion.
We're going to miss them. It's like having them torn from our bosom.
Just love them all so much. But you know what they say? What ship will never sink? A friendship.
First up is Charlotte and her fluttering vagina.
I've done nothing with my hair.
It's lovely. It's like a swatch of silk. It's in such good condition.
It's not mine.
Whose hair is it? Jevon's?
Last agency visit. None you needed. Let's have ya.
What does this remind you of?
Day one.
Day one.
Charlotte Crosby comes in and tells us her type.
Why, oh, why are we talking about willies again? I'll play a video.
What about if you ask them, how many inches are you?
What about that? This date is getting better and better.
The next guy, Jevon.
Jevon makes us feel sick.
I think next time we're going to have babies. I'm so disappointed in you.
I said I'm a slag.
Type in his name and we're all over the internet. So he's actually sold this story.
Oh, what a little cross.
You are 20.
I've got a kid.
Brad! It is a bit upsetting. I think this could be love. I've got one! It's been a great experience and I have met someone who made us feel like I just wanted to see them.
That is huge, Charlotte.
It turns out that not all guys are wankers and I succeeded in doing what I thought was impossible. I got over Gary!
Hooray!
Oh, yeah.
Tyger.
Seen you in a little while.
Well.
Do you think you have learned to show people the real Charlotte rather than the TV Charlotte Crosby? Woo, hey.
People see us on telly and think I'm a slag, but I don't sleep around, and me not getting with Brad is the real me.
Do you think that you know who the real Charlotte Crosby is?
I definitely think I know who the real Charlotte Crosby is, but I don't know whether I can let her out yet. I don't know whether people would still like us as much.
The real Charlotte Crosby is a beautiful, wonderful human being.
Thank you. That means a lot. I don't want to cry again like when I was first here. But it has. It's been such an amazing experience. I have actually come out of this learning so much.
Oh, you're setting me off now. Someone get me a tissue.
There is a real me deep down in there somewhere, and from now on, I'm gonna let her out more often. Watch out, world!
Oh, God.
One last thing, the banquet.
How are you feeling? I'm excited. Obviously, I'm excited. We're all gonna be getting together. Mm. And I know I'm gonna take Brad. We'll just see what happens. Brad is fucking awesome. He's fit, he's funny, and I just can't wait to introduce him to everybody.
Oh, Charlotte. Next on the scene, it's robot botherer Tyger.
I'm hating the thought of all the people that won't be visiting anymore.
You have one of the most amazing personalities I've ever come across, seriously.
Ah, oh, so lovely, I could cry.
Oh, that's lovely. Well, ditto, right back at you.
Well, thank you.
Since joining the agency, he's been on the hunt to find a beautiful lady and a cure for talking shit.
It was weird having a camera crew film me have sex with a robot.
I guess that could put some girls off. You don't boil the chicken, do you?
What is he doing?
This is the first time I've seen you be a bitch.
You're not an idiot.
No, I'm not an idiot. You're right.
I just liked her. It is a shame.
You were right. End of story.
There you go.
Let's just shut you up.
This sounds really, really wrong, but I would love to slaughter an animal.
It's kind of getting a bit painful now.
Would you possibly like to go on a date with me?
I'd love to go on a date.
You would?
I would.
She said yes.
I don't think anyone else was anywhere near as nice as you.
Oh, so sweet. Thank you.
So let's talk about the things that you have learned.
Chat.
Hello.
Okay, my chat was shit. It's okay now, right?
Are you sure about that?
Well, I think you're both sick. I mean, you're so sick, you're decomposing, literally. Like, I think you're really quite awesome.
Oh, Tyger, you was doing so well with your chat.
Decomposition is not the best thing. You're dead.
Yeah, but that means that's how sick you are. Maybe it was the wrong choice of words, but yeah, I think you're both awesome. But I do feel like I've learned quite a bit. And also about myself.
With you particularly, I think we've got nothing but a celebration. Because we made the second date club.
Yeah, I know.
Woo-hoo-hoo! Second date. Yes, son.
I just got to join the Mile High Club.
Smooth, Tyger. Real smooth.
Well, we can't do anything about that, but, you know.
I'm quite pleased, to be honest, that it didn't actually work out with the other dates because I feel like I've met someone really special in Frankie. Thank fuck I don't have to shag a robot again, eh?
Welcome back to Celebs Go Dating. After 3 weeks of dating you lot, it's time for our single stars to choose someone to invite to the dinner party. Tyger's taken student Frankie as his plus one.
I feel like I've met someone really special in Frankie.
And Charlotte's bringing Brad from Grimsby.
Brad is fucking awesome. Can't wait to introduce him to everybody.
Right, let's get back to the agency where Jack has arrived for his final consultation with Nadia and Eden. Do we know why he always wears sunglasses inside? That's better.
I miss you guys, man.
This is it.
If you could go back to Jack that we met at the start of this process,
yeah,
what advice would you give him?
Just listen. And do more pranks on your dates.
For fuck's sake. Yeah, because that's always worked out, ain't it, mate?
I'm the funny guy, the prank star.
Are you pranking me?
I can be a bit of a dick sometimes. I was wondering, Trin, is any chance I get a kiss on the cheek?
Oh, my God.
Wait, careful, it's flight away, it's flying robot. Oh, no, it's behind you.
Fucking annoyed me, like, definitely female,
I'm
actually female.
Obviously, I apologise.
Maybe not everything I find funny is funny.
You got me a glass of wine?
It's actually my mum.
Is your mum here?
Just kidding!
Shireen did me so good. That just made me like even more. A girl that can prank me is hot.
Shireen could be girlfriend material.
Yeah, I think I might be taking her to the dinner.
Okay. And you think she's up for that?
Yeah, I hope so.
I feel like it's the sort of the guy that turns it around at the last minute.
Totally.
You know, you lose the girl, you get the girl. You lose the girl, you get the girl.
You kick the girl in the bush?
The ball is very much in Shireen's court now. I've tried my best to get us back on track, so I just hope she turns up.
Cross town at a photo shoot, Joey Essex is dealing with a weighty issue.
I'm just scared of soy, because apparently soy can give you boobs. But soy milk, it contains estrogen. Or estrogen?
Estrogen.
Estrogen, and will give you man boobs.
You're all right.
Oh, I think I'm all right at the moment. I think I'm perfectly fine.
Joey has a busy morning ahead of him. But all anyone wants to know is who's Joey taking to tonight's dinner party.
I can't wait to take Steph to the dinner party. We are going to be the pengiest couple there. Pengiest!
Yes, yes, I'm Joey Essex, and today I'm giving away some sick holidays. Wallet.
Next up is Paisley.
Well, this is it.
Yeah.
I know.
Last day in the agency.
I know. Are you going to miss me?
Of course.
Paisley was our biggest project, and I'm so proud of how far she's come.
I don't really, like, do dates,
There's been good times.
How are you, darling?
Good, how are you? I feel like a big girl now. Like, I've been on my first date. Bad times.
And unfortunately, he doesn't want to go on a second date.
Awkward times. Are you for real?
Right.
Oh, he's really cute.
I don't think I can.
Do you want to go on a date?
Oh,
say
yeah,
yes.
Yes, that's it.
But all of it has been one hell of a lesson.
Do you remember what you rated yourself when, on the very first day?
I do. I was a 6.5.
Would you like to review that figure at all?
Yeah.
And?
9.
You will rate yourself 9 out of 10?
Yes.
Holy fucking shit, boss.
Steady on now, Nadia. We get you a little excited.
My confidence has rocketed through this process. I've had some knocks along the way, but they've made me a hell of a lot stronger.
That is awesome.
I know.
You literally have grown from a 16-year-old girl that came through to this woman that's in front of us.
Yeah.
That thinks nothing now about asking a guy out.
I know. What have you done to me?
Meanwhile, downstairs...
Hello, Celebrity Dating Agency.
Hey, Tom, it's Steph.
Hello.
Oh, come in.
What have you learned about dating?
Oh, where do I even start? I've learned you probably shouldn't pick up your steak knife unless it's to cut your steak.
Eh?
Not to sit around if someone's going to be a dickhead. Walk away. I've learned not to scream when someone goes in to kiss you.
Thank God.
Tonight I get to celebrate how far I've come on this dating journey, and I get to celebrate with Davide by my side.
Meanwhile, in reception...
Sweet. How things go with Jeff?
It's just another world. Joey's like a boy toy.
A boy toy? What the fuck is that?
He's so twinkly, isn't he? Naughty, twinkly little boy. He's got an air of magic.
Bless. Tommy's still in love with Joey. He must secretly hate Steph.
Stephanie Pratt has been a difficult one. She doesn't know what she wants, but she does know what she doesn't want. Hopefully, she's come to realize that.
No one ever approaches me.
Where's it going wrong?
I tend to go for gay guys.
I actually got circumcised 3 weeks ago.
Jack, you're a dream. I've got that wall.
The most challenging part of this process has definitely been learning about myself.
What?
I honestly didn't expect it to be this difficult.
I don't think I'm ready to be exclusive yet.
I need to get past my own issues.
What do you want to do? Do you want to go out on a date or not?
Oh, I'm so happy that I've met Joey. I've come so far. Could he be the one? Potentially.
Shall we talk?
Yes.
About Joey.
Let's be honest. That's why we're all here.
So, Joey Essex, as it stands, yes or no?
Yeah. I never thought that I would fall for Joey Essex. But this is the real deal. I haven't felt like this about anyone for years.
I told ya, from the beginning, Jeff.
Tell me, what have you learnt from the process?
I thought that because I hadn't been on a date in 8 months, it was because guys don't approach me at the bar. But really, I was just hiding. Because it was safe to protect myself.
How did you feel, like, realizing, holy shit, like, I'm not who I thought I was?
I think it was just sad. I feel like I'm on the way to deserving love.
Right, let's leave Mrs. Essex to it. Mr. Essex has arrived for his final consultation.
You're always staring at me every time I turn up at this agency to sort them eyebrows out, mate. There you go, son. Ta-ta.
Ta-ta, Joe.
Ooh.
Oh, darling.
These two have such chemistry. Forget about Jeff. I'm team John.
Ooh. I can't bear this, you know. This what? Is the last time you'll cross my threshold.
Oh, is it really?
Mm.
Well, this is my last time in the blessed office of Joey Essex. Is it really?
It is.
Oh, shit.
I know, it's not so blessed now, is it? I shall be utterly bereft without you.
Do you want to bless you now, Tom?
Yes, please.
Tom, I bless you.
Oh, I feel better already.
Do you?
Yeah.
There you go.
Stop flirting and play the video.
You look like you're absolutely ripe for love.
What type of girl are you looking for at the moment?
Blonde,
beautiful,
obviously blue eyes. I was hoping to meet some pen girls.
Oh. Wait.
What the hell?
I need someone to save me in this sad moment of Joe Essex's life.
Becky was ping.
I do really like you, but got to date other people.
But she wasn't ping enough for me. And I've met the pingiest girl ever.
Dating Steph is breaking the rules. The fact now that you are sort of openly out there, I wonder if there's going to be the same chemistry. Because...
What do you mean, now it's done?
Well, yeah, exactly.
I like her. She's nice.
You have no idea how much hard work we put in behind the scenes.
I know, and I respect that, and you put in hard work and it's worked. How can you not say it's worked?
It hasn't worked, though.
It will work.
Mate, I've got birds. You've chosen the wrong person.
Nadia needs to chill out. Like, they should be happy for me.
Meanwhile, in reception...
Hang about, where's Tommy boy?
He's hot-footed it across London to set the dinner.
What a stupendous night it's going to be. I'm just so excited.
Meanwhile, back at the agency.
So what's the biggest thing that you've learned?
For girls not to be on me.
If girls
are on me, it's just like you're too on me.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Get off me, do you know what I mean?
If you could sum the whole thing up in one word.
What would it be? One word. Proper sick.
That's two words, Joey.
That's bait, though, isn't it? You know he's been sick.
That's bait. But you're peng, so that's salty with me, bruv. Somewhere in swanky central London, it's dinner party time. And whilst Tom puts in the hard graft...
I'm going to lift this sleeve.
Nadia and Eden are tucking into the champers.
Cheers, Alan. How exciting.
God, I'm looking forward to this.
Give him an hand, guys.
These 3 weeks have been building towards tonight.
I think I'm most nervous about Jack.
Me too.
Is Shireen going to turn up? Yeah. Is she going to give him a second chance?
And the thing is, we don't know.
If Joey walks in with Stephanie, we're going to have to pick people's jaws up.
Oh, we'll be scooping them up. People will be tripping over them.
All we need now are our famous faces. First to arrive, it's Charlotte.
Hello! Yeah!
Tyger!
Woo! Hide the knives, it's Paisley.
Yeah!
Still wearing sunglasses indoors, Jack Jones.
Hey. What's up, guys?
Is that everyone, Detective Crosby?
Hughes, where do you think Joey and Steph are?
Well, you know, London's a busy city. They could be coming from separate places.
London's a busy city. They could be coming from separate continents.
Oh, don't mention coming around, Charlotte Crosby. Red rag to a bull.
Oh, they could be coming in each other.
Charlotte!
What did I say?
Let's meet their date.
Was in to see Charlotte tonight. Things seem to be going really well.
Hey, guys, you alright? I'm doing very right.
Hi, Brad. Looking good.
Securing Tyger a second date. Frankie's here.
I'm really excited that Tyger's picked me to go to the dinner party with him. I really like him. He's really sweet. We get on really well.
Have you ever heard of the phrase punching above your weight?
You said it, not me. It's Davide.
Hello. Hi.
Ever the professionals, the agents haven't told the other celebs about showbiz's hottest new couple, Jeff. It's impossible to know where he ends and she begins.
You're so cute, aren't we?
You're so cute.
You're so cute.
I am so excited to walk into this dinner party with Steph. Everyone's gonna be like, what? It's gonna be sick.
Welcome back to Celebs Go Dating. The celebs aren't technically dating anymore as they're going to a final celebrity dating agency dinner party with their chosen plus ones. Question is, will they all turn up?
Where the fuck are Joey and Steph?
I am so excited to walk into this dinner party with Steph. Everyone's gonna be like, what?
It's time for the main event. Celebs meet Jeff.
Hey, oh. Hey, hey.
I fucking knew it!
Steph, why didn't you tell me?
Boy.
You're holding his hand!
Steph and Joey are holding hands. Did I miss something?
Keep up.
Oh, it's so lovely to see you!
Are you dating Joey tonight?
With grins like that on their faces, they've definitely had a bit of finger action in the cab on the way here.
Well, what the fuck? I just screamed at her because she never told me.
I thought the whole point of this thing was to date someone who's not a celeb.
What, someone like Jet Jones?
Bro, what have you brought?
If she comes. So I don't know.
If she comes.
I have no idea, mate, so I don't know if she's got to turn up or not. Jeez,
what?
I have no idea.
What is going on with Jack? Where's his date?
Yeah, Shireen has been invited, but Jack doesn't know for sure whether she's coming or not.
Jack's been stood up.
Is that it? Plenty more fish in the sea, sweetie.
Awkward.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I grab your attention, if we can move through to the main banquet, as I believe we're all here.
Awesome.
Follow me.
Just rock and roll.
Start it out, Jack. At least you get two dinners.
Ta-da!
Wow!
It's
like Christmas. Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats.
Sure, yeah. Frankie looks hot. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I definitely made the right choice for the dinner party.
I've been a very busy bee. What a stupendous night it's going to be. I'm just so excited.
Yes, Brad.
Yes.
All right, you two, get a room.
Your hunk. Prince of Wales, Jeff.
Did you just call him a hunk?
Yes.
Is Davide going to speak? Maybe not.
Davide's fit, he's lovely and polite. I'm literally winning tonight.
Thank you all for coming. We are over the moon to see so many happy couples at this table.
Apart from me.
Awkward.
Got an imaginary friend there.
It may be that not everyone has found love.
Don't worry, Bridget. I mean, Jack.
Defining love. Cheers, everyone. Cheers!
Cheers!
Oh, Jack.
Well, I feel like a bit of a mug. Everyone's got a date, apart from me.
Cheers. Cheers, guys.
Yes, Brad.
Cheers, mate. Cheers, bro.
Look lively. Here she comes.
Glad that she turned up. Jack's been shitting himself. Hard.
Sounds painful.
Banging outfit, though.
Do you like it?
Eyes on the face, Jack. Eyes on the face. Dinner is commencing, and it's all very civilised. But don't worry, guys, it gets very pissed and shouty very soon.
Brad!
Told ya. This is technically Tyger's second date. Hopefully, the other 13 guests will distract from any of his terrible chat.
How much, jewellery do you normally wear on your hands?
Oh, God. Moving on!
So, can I ask you to do a question, please? A serious question. Would you two ever sort of consider doing bits of each other?
Joey.
Nadia was asked a question the other week, and before I opened my mouth, she went, I wouldn't shit on my own doorstep.
Excellent question, Dodgy.
I wouldn't either, to be honest.
Will someone please explain it to Joey?
No, like, I hook up with someone at work.
Oh, okay, of course, yeah.
Oh, Joey.
Lies. Them saying they haven't done bits, that's like me saying me and Steph ain't done bits. Do you get me?
I think that's a showbiz exclusive.
Just being very nosy and asking about your last one. Where did you go and what did you get out of?
Went to a bar in Brixton.
I would have been just round the corner from
in
you.
Your ends, Brian.
Yeah, in my hood. So Wagwan in my hood.
Oh, my God!
Paisley. She doesn't seem to know nearly how delicious she is. And she's warm and funny and fun. I adore her.
Everyone seems to be getting on really well.
In your opinion, over the course of this process, who do you think has been the most like teacher's pet?
You had to go and ruin it, didn't you, Tyger?
I think that everybody's really tried. because there is not a spare seat in the house. So that means you must have tried because everyone's got a date. But my personal star pupil has to go. To Paisley.
Woo! I'm the star pupil. Yes, I am. I am the star.
Is she for real?
I was pre-star, though, weren't I?
You were, Joey.
Until I fucked up.
No, you didn't fuck up, you just broke the rule.
Oh, it's happening. We've gone up a gear.
Are you happy?
Of course I'm happy.
But you were not singing that tune yesterday.
We haven't done anything wrong. We're going by what you said, Steph. You told us you didn't like Joey, and now you're saying, oh, we're in love, we're in love. Is this bullshit or what's going on?
Do you feel like we're making look bad because you didn't do your job? I'm just kidding.
Fight!
I'm just kidding. You guys did an incredible job. I was just trying to get you back. I'm sorry.
Bullshit.
You guys, I want you to be happy. I love love. That's what I do for a living. Like, if you guys are in love, which hopefully you're on the way to, what more can we ask for?
I reckon Steph and Joey have got loads in common. Well, skincare products, at least.
Is it official, Joe?
Of course they are. Look at the chemistry. It's transparent.
Oh, Tom's a legend.
How does Tom feel about his celebrity crush being with Steph?
Not at the supper table. Alas, it may not be with me, but beneath that thin veil of naughtiness lies a heart-beating romantic in Joey.
And Tom's not the only one who feels protective over Joey.
I feel like Steph might hurt Joey.
Oh.
Easy there, Charlotte.
Things are getting tense.
Only because she's a strong, guarded woman. And you're a little bit of a puppy dog.
Somebody say something.
Steph is gonna fuck Joey over so hard. He's a boy and she's a woman. This is just a fling.
Blimey, Charlotte. How are things going across the other side of the table?
I'm gonna go to the toilet, you
know? Yeah, mind you fancy, yeah. Did Joey just ask Brad to go to the loo with him? I thought it was into Steph.
Guys, I need to catch up with you.
Yeah, hello.
Good to see you.
And you? Great hair, by the way.
Really?
Yeah.
You taking the piss?
No, I'm being serious.
Are you taking the piss?
It's really nice that Shireen is making an effort. I think Jack seems to have picked a good one.
Scores on one, civil.
Do you want to sit there and some catch up?
Huh? No. Catch up? You haven't even met him before.
It's all right. I know her.
She was chatting to her.
Yeah. Anyway, so our conversation over two people now.
So how are you anyway?
Good, how are you?
Thanks.
How have your dates been?
Oh, I can't watch.
What the hell are you doing, man? It's like the most awkward, weird conversation I've heard in my life.
I'm not entirely sure what's happening here.
Well, we were actually having a conversation until you interrupted it and started giving your comments.
What? Oh,
so.
Wow, is this how we're going? All right, cool.
Come on, let's be friends.
Sweet.
What the fuck is wrong with Jack?
There's no reason to be like that. You literally just came with your comment and then we were having a chat.
Anyway,
and
dude, right, yeah.
Yeah, I'm good, man. How are you? Let's
go over, man.
This is actually ridiculous.
Don't know about you, but I'd rather shit me hand and clap than stay in this room any longer.
Is this a joke? She turns up late and then storms off.
What the fuck is going on? Come here!
Shireen comes into the bathroom crying her eyes out. What the actual fuck?
I was sat in Jack's seat and he was like, what are you doing? Like, you're gonna move?
He wishes his voice was that deep.
So I moved back to my seat and then he sat down, he grabbed a drink and he was like, well, this is the stupidest, awkwardest conversation I've ever had.
To be fair, I sort of saw this coming.
Me too.
It seems like Jack and Shireen have had loads of ups and downs already.
Back at the dinner table, Charlotte hasn't talked about pubes or vagina all night. Something's up.
I need to speak to you and Nardi in our room.
What's up?
Having a hard time.
Why?
Just not feeling Brad. I can really see myself being with Brad, but now I'm starting to question things.
He ate the salmon, right, and then spat it back out all over the plate.
And I mean, I know I'm a bit vulgar sometimes.
No shit, Sherlock.
I'm sitting next to like 20 meters spitting salmon out on the plate.
So what are you saying?
I'm just very scared because I just don't ever want to hurt his feelings. I'm very nervous. I'm gonna have to tell him.
Honesty is the best policy.
I've got to tell him, haven't I?
Yeah. I feel so nervous. I just don't know how I'm gonna say this.
Welcome back to the final part of Celebs Go Dating. Like most celebrity relationships, we'll last about another 15 minutes. Tyger's smashing his second date.
What's your bedtime?
Normally goes to bed about 10.
Really? Of 10?
Still not sure if she knows about the old robot fucking. Paisley looks like she's on for another snog tonight.
Did you just call him a hunk?
Yeah.
Charlotte's being frosty.
Brad.
And Jeff are, well, getting off with each other. A lot. Shirin turned up. But then she stormed out again.
Is this a joke? But
then she's back again.
That's what I don't understand.
Me either.
Oh, that looks wonderful.
Time for the main course, but it looks like someone's lost their appetite.
What?
Are you serious? You're
actually... They're at it again.
You turn up really late, and I come here, I try, like, saying, you're right, how you doing? Like, it's really nice to see you now. And you pay no interest. You start talking to these guys more.
How was I not interested in talking to you?
And then blank me.
I was like, can I have a minute,
like that,
is what I said.
Hey, can I speak? You blank me like that.
Yeah, I don't think they'll be going on another date.
Shireen, what's the deal? Chill, man.
I'm just having conversation with the girl I know.
Chill, no, but you're like
you
getting louder.
You know, I don't know, I've done nothing wrong.
Yeah, but you're just getting louder and louder and you're sort of causing a scene.
Because
chill
you're upsetting
out,
me,
man.
For because I'm meant to be warm with
out,
guys,
Brad,
stop
you
it, man. It's not that your argument to be involved in, just leave them to it.
Ah, we love a good old domestic at the dinner table.
See, but now it's quieter.
Well then, Charlotte.
It's quieter now, isn't it?
This is the aggiest episode of Come Dine With Me I've ever seen.
I think you should apologise to her.
No, like, I've just said, like, look, like, why?
No, because...
You to chill out, that's all I said.
Brad.
Wait, how do I explain the flash?
If you were a man, you would go for it and say, I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, but now you're patronising her.
You don't do anything if you don't feel like you need to.
Well, this dinner party has turned to shit. She's off again. Fucking hell, they're dropping like flies at this table.
It is kicking off left, right and centre.
Outside, I'm not sure Charlotte's taken Brad out for that elusive snog.
I feel so nervous. I just don't know how I'm going to say this. But you know I have a lovely time with you.
Yeah,
and I get on with you so well. And like, but I think you do show signs of immaturity sometimes. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Even just there when you said something to Shireen.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, Brad, I don't think this is going to end well, mate.
Doing this experience has made us like kind of find myself. I think I just need to have some time to focus on the real me.
Just a general question. I've like seen in the papers that you've got a fella.
I do not have a boyfriend in the slightest. I just don't feel like I can go back into there, like the table and like pretend, do you know what I mean?
Okay.
I was just.
Look, right, we'll call it this, yeah? And I'll get myself off. So you get yourself in there with the rest of them and have a good night, yeah?
All right.
Have a good night anyway, babe.
Bye.
Oh, Brad, you've been custard pied before dessert's even been served.
Oh, God. I feel so bad.
Back at the dinner table. Time for your just desserts. No, it's just actually time for dessert.
Actually, that is very, very good.
Out on the stairs, Shireen's still not happy with Jack.
What's going on, babes?
I can make some coconut sorbet sometime.
Okay.
So good.
It's banging, isn't it?
Yeah, man. I want to steal that one so much.
This pudding is delicious, and Shireen seems long gone. Wait, keep my spoon though.
Are you nicking people's food, Paige?
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, let's just chill, relax, and it's got some nice coconut pudding.
Shit, this is awkward.
I know you like coconut pudding.
Come on, darling, let's go get your pudding.
Oh, God.
Oh, God, I've eaten her pudding and she's back.
The panna cotta is delicious, by the way, darlings.
Someone eat a coconut?
Someone's actually eaten my coconut.
Someone stole your coconut.
This is so embarrassing.
Paisley.
He just threw you under the bus there. At least you didn't cartwheel into it, eh, Tyger?
I'm sorry, OK? It tasted
wow.
really good.
As Brad leaves the party, Charlotte's in tears again. Charlotte, why are you crying? Brad's the one who's been dumped.
Charlotte. I've done the hard bit, but now I've got to face everyone else. Oh, I just feel so bad.
What feels so bad?
Just, I explained to Brad how I felt. Mm-hmm. Obviously, that he was too young and that I just didn't see a future or anything.
Oh, it's okay. Don't feel bad.
I don't want to lead him on or make him feel like something might happen when I know that it won't. It's not fair to him.
Exactly. So it's better that you're honest.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Really took it so well. I can't even describe how well he took it. He was so nice. He actually offered to leave.
I sort of see it coming anyway. Do you know the age thing? It was always, she sort of had a guard up about it from the start. It weren't really any surprise, to be fair. I sort of knew when he was coming, but I'm taking it on the chin, and it is what it is.
Well, Brad, you can only get older. Back at the dinner table.
Let's get a drink, then. I just need to get drunk.
Yeah.
Where is the bloody booze?
For a dinner party celebrating the end of a dating show, this has been well dramatic. Has anyone actually found love? We know Pratt's been in Essex, but Charlotte is desperate to know if Essex has been in Pratt.
I know yous have had sex.
No, we ain't.
I know yous have.
We ain't.
We have not.
We have not. We ain't. The same thing.
Steph, tell us later.
Do Ken and Barbie dolls have genitals?
Joey.
Yes.
What's your favourite highlight of process?
Probably have to be meeting Steph.
Oh. I think it's wicked that Steph and Joey are together. They're really well suited and they look so cute tonight.
Now, Nadia might think that Steph and Joey is the worst idea in the world, but I've got to be honest with you, I think it's kind of cute.
All right, Mr. Jones.
Obviously meeting Shireen, so I was still here. We might have argued a lot, had our ups and downs, but had some really good times as well, and that's what I think's probably kept us together. So, yeah, that's probably about it.
Okay, let's take bets. Who's going to split out first?
I think it would have been in the speed date. The talent was all on a high level, but not quite as talented as that one, so.
Nice answer.
Yeah, nice one.
I think Tyger and Frankie are on their way to date number three.
I can't believe our first kiss was in front of everyone. But I guess that just shows how much I like her.
Yeah, Miss Paisley.
Oh, my God. So, I feel like my favourite moment...
Is Daffoday going to speak?
..of everything was last night, right? So, like, me and Daffoday had had a couple drinks, and we got on a date, and we'd had a little cuddle. Hey. And then we kissed, and I screamed!
I think it's just the moment that you all found somebody you clicked with. I think that's just lovely. And I have to say, from the bottom of my heart, I'm going to miss you all terribly.
I miss you loads as well.
All of you.
Oh, don't, I'm going to cry.
Just cry.
Let it out.
I didn't even think that Nadia could cry.
Sorry.
Oh.
I know I'm crying because of
tears. Nadia.
You all were completely honest and completely open. Thank you.
Oh, Nadia! I'm okay, so happy tears, I promise you, it's good.
I cry happy tears sometime too, but I won't go into that now.
Well done, everyone. Congratulations.
Cheers.
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 To the agents
now.
Well done.
Steph and Joey snogging has been absolutely sick, and I mean in the proper old-fashioned sense. Get a room. As the other celebs head home, power couple Jeff have snuck off for a snog. All right, mate.
Did you ever think that you would end up falling in love with a boy from Essex?
I can't believe that I found a guy that I'm actually really falling for.
You know what the scariest thing is, though?
What?
Is it's the last day, and this is always the day that I get dumped.
Well, why don't we just say for now that we're exclusive?
Exclusive. I think that's an exclusive.
It's a perfect ending.
Mm. I think me and Steph, we're quite genuine. And I feel like we're going to prove a lot of people wrong, to be honest.
I not only hope that Charlotte will find love, but I truly believe she will, because I know that beneath the carapace beats an incredible romantic. That's why we get on, the kindred spirits in that regard.
We want to just be in love with someone and only have sex with them for the rest of our lives.
And they say romance is dead. For fuck's sake. So after 3 weeks, 6 celebrities and 10 dates, 3 burps, 1 circumcision, 3 walkouts, and that song...
Don't be afraid, there's nothing to fear, let's go.
Yep, that one. It's nearly all over. How are you feeling, guys?
I just never want to see another celebrity ever again in my life.
I'd look away now then, Eden, as we're about to see our shiny new couple's first celebrity photo shoot.
Frankie has made this whole thing for me.
Come on, Tyger.
Thank fuck I didn't quit, or else I wouldn't have met Davide.
I'm not just a prankster, I have a soft side too, and it just takes a certain girl to bring that out of me.
That's it.
Is that right,
that? Joey.
I don't
know. I think we're a brilliant match, yeah.
I think we're a perfect match.
Yeah, we are, aren't we?
Things that I like about Davide, okay, right, look at him. Like, most seriously, look at him.
Tyger's chat is not dull. Some terrible jokes.
Yeah.
But I quite like it. I don't think he's dull at all.
Look at that, at your boobs.
I definitely prefer the Jack who I've been with on my dates. The Jack who throws girls in the mission.
I might have just met the future Mrs. Essex.
I'm just sorry that I can't satisfy you.
I think the dancing will be enough.
Yeah, I think a really good dance can be really titillating.
What does that mean, to get your tits out?